up YouTube? Topaz Jace back for another album review, and this one is to that Slim Thug Hogg Life Volume 4 American King, another in a line of really quality albums that Slim Thug has released, man. This one, he's going much deeper into socially conscious topics and everything, man, but in the end, the quality of music has just been there, because as I said on multiple projects, man, not just from Slim Thug, but yet from others, man, is that you reach this point where you no longer care about succeeding in the music industry, because you're ultimately not going to get the promotion that the record labels is pushing for everybody else. So instead, you focus on creating the best music you possibly can for the fan base that's rocking with you right now. And Slim Thug has done that for pretty much all four of these projects that he released. Even though Slim Thug is not the best lyricist, his flow and his delivery isn't perfected at all, man. He still can create quality tracks, man, and a quality product, and that's exactly what we got. My favorite songs off this would be that King, where he's ultimately talking about how everybody can build themselves up to be a king, man, and that is 100% true, because this world that we're living in right now ain't nothing but a sandbox for you to go ahead and build something out of. It's like only you can stop yourself from doing that. I like that Enemy track where he's ultimately talking about how black people ultimately hate on him, hate on everything that he's trying to do, and how black people, we hardly ever come together and such. And I feel him to a degree on that, because it's too prevalent in the black community for people to go ahead and throw down another black person so that they can try to rise up. I understand all that, but that whole mindset is really within the dusty individuals, man. Like, there's a lot of well-to-do black people that want to help other well-to-do black people out. So ultimately, it's not a broad characteristic of black people, because I personally run with some really well-to-do black people that's out here trying to get it, bruh. So no, we can't ignore that it exists within the dusty communities and everything, man, but we need to band together as people that are well-to-do black people and go ahead and push forward, because if you go back to, say, the Million Man March and all of that, man, there was a lot of well-to-do black people that came out there, while a lot of dusty and coons and all of them, they really avoided that. But yet that original Million Man March, not having all the black people, was still powerful enough to resonate to this day. I like that Family track where he's ultimately talking about people who aren't actually his blood, but yet they are ultimately family, and this is just something real right here that he definitely needed to touch on. Just because somebody is blood related to you does not mean you are stuck with that individual, man. Like, too often you give too many people chances and stuff that are blood related to you simply off that strength, when you got people that aren't blood related to you that'll never do you wrong like your family will do you. Doesn't matter who you related to, man, you can pick and choose who you surround yourself with, and that's something that people need to do so you don't set yourself up for failure. I like that Hustle with Zero on it, where he's ultimately talking about the grind, man, of getting up every day, going out to get that success, and that's something that everybody needs to do. Like, Slim Thug has been in the game for a very long time. He should not be grinding harder than all of these dudes out here who's saying that they want to be part of the game, but yet sadly he is, and you can obviously see with this being the fourth album that he's dropped in such a brief amount of time. I like that Get Rich track, where it's a lot like the King track, where he's ultimately telling people, you can go out here and get rich, man. Ain't nothing stopping you. And I could go on and on, man, because this album honestly rides from top to bottom, man. The only thing I would say about it, he's not giving us a classic hit out of it. We're getting a bunch of really good songs, though. So I overall give this joint an 8 out of 10, one I recommend you go ahead and purchase, dude. But this concludes today's review, and now we're going to jump into a brief instrumental from Underground Producers. Rap strong before we jump into the news, and then jump into an article from downloadpaz.com. So did you guys see that ASAP Yam's book has got a release date for August the 12th and such, man, in which they're selling it for $40, and all of the proceeds of it is going to go to the ASAP Foundation that they created in dedication to Yams who died over a drug overdose, in which the charity is pretty much for kids who's battling drug abuse. Excellent stuff right there, man. Definitely one thing that I'm going to be looking out for. But anyway, on today's article from downloadpaz.com, and today's article is about standing up for yourself, man, because it's really important to do this, because too many people are too passively aggressive on everything, you feel me? Like, there comes a line that if anybody crosses that, they have to have repercussions for it. Because if you let them do it, they're going to constantly walk past that line and they're going to expect you to take that. If you don't set your standards, man, then ultimately you're going to allow everybody to walk all over you. So ultimately, know what you're worth. Know your limits, man, and go out and get that and enforce those, man, and forget about all that. I'ma just be nice just because I don't want no problems. Sometimes there got to be problems, bruh. I hope you enjoyed the show. You can follow me at Twitter up there, and you can go to downloadpads.com, that's down there, to read today's article.